Want to get Infinite Marvel's Avengers Upgrade modules without restarting the game? Of course you do, so this is what I'm going to show you guys in this video, but besides the fact that I'm going to show you how to get them, I am also going to share with you 3 awesome upgrade modules farming locations that you'll just love. So welcome back friends, Vlad here, and before we begin I want to thank each and every one of you for the support on yesterday's video on how to farm patterns. It truly means a lot to me and your likes and comments are truly appreciated. That's why today I woke up early to get this video done as soon as possible so you can take full advantage of it before the next patch releases. I'm not sure if Crystal Dynamics will fix this glitch because it is a glitch, but I will keep you updated in the comments section below as usual. Good, so before we begin I want to clarify something because I have seen a lot of comments regarding the loot on various difficulty levels. Let's clear this, although I have mentioned it in all of my videos. The difficulty level affects the quality and the quantity of the loot. As such, in this video I am going to show you 3 Marvel's Avengers Infinite Upgrade Modules farming spots and we will play them on 3 difficulty levels. On easy difficulty, as you will see, we'll get 1 upgrade module, on normal and hard 2 upgrade modules, and on brutal 3 upgrade modules. Also, the best thing about this farming method is that you don't have to reload the game, you don't have to restart the mission, and you don't have to return to the Quinjet. This is why what I am going to show you next is the fastest Marvel's Avengers upgrade modules farming method to date. So, let's begin with the first location, which is our beloved Snowy Tundra Vault mission. The reason for visiting it is an elite enemy that spawns close to the starting point. What we need to do is to pay him a visit and you'll find him behind the front gate on the right side of the area. While we get there, let me tell you how this farming method works. As you know, most open area missions feature elite enemies with little helmets above their heads. They represent points of interest that are marked by Jarvis for you. We also know that elite enemies drop upgrade modules every time you kill them, with the quantity being determined by the difficulty level. Our goal is to make the elite enemy constantly respawn. While this may sound complicated, it's actually extremely easy, as you are about to see. All you have to do is to find an elite enemy, then kill him while keeping the remaining mobs alive. Even if one survives, it's enough. Otherwise, the location will be considered completed and you'll have to restart. So, simply put, all you have to do is to kill the main target and try to protect the enemies that always spawn nearby. Once you deal with the elite enemy, grab the loot, then step away from his area, which is called spawning area, and after several seconds, if you return, he will respawn and you can kill him again, obviously getting another upgrade module, or more depending on the difficulty level. Here, you can see that after I deal with the elite, I quickly head back to the main gate in this area, then return and kill him again. And you can do this for as much as you want. The faster you kill him and the faster you move, the better. That's why a flying character is recommended, but you can do this with all Avengers. Before we move to the next location, I hope you have noticed that this elite dropped only 1 upgrade module because we are playing on easy. The second farming spot for upgrade modules is Stark Realities in Pacific Northwest and we will play it on hard. Here, as you probably know, we have an elite enemy close to a small bunker with a golden chest. The idea is the same, and when you start the mission, head right, then left and fly over the large base. In front of a bunker, an elite will spawn, so we are going to nuke him as fast as possible while keeping the other mobs nearby alive. Once he's dead, he'll drop 2 upgrade modules because we are playing, as I said, on hard, so we grab them quickly and exit his spawning area by flying or running away towards the enemy base nearby. And that is all we have to do. Let's do this one more time a bit faster. As you can see, we are using the same strategy. Good then, so let's see the last farming spot I have for you, then I am going to share with you several tips. The third one is the Day of the Remains faction mission, and we are going to play it on brutal because we will get 3 modules per enemy killed. This one goes even faster because the elite enemy is right in front of the starting point, so if you play Thor or Iron Man, you'll get there really fast. In my case, the elite is called Shockmat and it has a shield. This is the enemy I have to kill to get the modules, and once I do that, I quickly fly away from his area, then return. Notice that I am getting 3 upgrade modules, which should clarify the whole debate if increasing the difficulty level affects the loot. Yes, it does, and you'll get more materials for playing on Brutal and also better gear. But when we say better, we talk about rarity and stats, not power level. So, before I move to the tips, let me share with you how many modules you'll most likely get. I killed Shockmat over here on Brutal 5 times in 5 minutes, which means that I got a total of 15 modules in 5 minutes, or 3 modules per minute. This means that you can get at least 180 modules per hour, as long as you don't take breaks and you don't kill the mobs, which is basically insane. Right then, so here are the tips I wanted to share with you. First, to increase the amount of farmed upgrade modules, play on Brutal difficulty, no questions asked. If you can deal with Brutal difficulty, start with a lower level. Second, this method works better while playing as a flying character because you'll move a bit faster, but you can definitely do this with any Avenger you want. Third, at least one mob must survive after you kill the elite, otherwise a restart is required because the location is marked as completed. Fourth, in this video I have tried to cover 3 different locations to fit different stages you may have reached in the game, but it works on all elite enemies you encounter as long as they have a little helmet above their head. And finally, I suggest you to use this method to stock up on upgrade modules before the next patch, and if you need time to get them, go offline and do not install anything before you have more than enough upgrade modules. And that's it guys, I really hope this Marvel's Avengers upgrade modules farming method helps you in the game, and obviously I am here to answer all your questions. Also, don't forget to check back soon for more Marvel's Avengers guides, tips and tricks, and until next time, stay safe and have an amazing week.